Yo, you are listening to Johnell Young, actor, model. Know what I mean? Make sure y'all go see that new All Eyez On Me, Tupac, June 16th. We are here, branching out TV. Millie Rock on any block. Hey, holla at your guala. One.
I'm Dottie Peoples, and you're watching Branching Out.
Hi, everyone. I'm Glory Govan from Bass Wives LA, and you just caught me on Branching Out.
Hi, we're the Braxtons, and you're watching Branching Out.
You are watching Branching Out.
Wow, you look beautiful.
Thank you.
All right, hey, it's Blair Underwood watching Branching Out.
Not Bobby Jones, and I branch it out for real.
And it's a beautiful thing.
Branch now.
And I'm just excited to be back to celebrate the 20th anniversary.
Hi, this is Antroinette Branch, and we're with Branching Out. We're here with Johnell, and we're going to see what he got going on in Atlanta.
What's going on, Branching Out? Johnell Young from Staten Island, New York. Make sure y'all go see that new All Eyez On Me, June 16th. Also got another film coming out called Court, where I'll be playing Byron. Byron is, he's a really, really, really different type dude. He's a number one draft pick in the state of Georgia. And he's going through trials and tribulations coming up in high school. So it's not just about basketball, it's about women of empowerment. It's about a lot of the race card we pull, and it'll be in theaters next year very, very soon.
So, are you playing basketball on your own?
Yes, it's funny that you asked that because I'm still pursuing an NBA career. I'll be trying out for a few teams, the Lakers, the Clippers, and my hometown team, the Westchester Knicks, this coming summer. So, I'm doing the best of both worlds right now, trying to be great and just, you know, letting God order my steps. I'm playing a producer, the rapper, his name is Ray Love. He's from a group called Strictly Dope. Beginning of Tupac's early career, he wasn't called Tupac. I'm gonna let y'all go watch the movie and find out what we used to call him. But playing his best friend in it, it's a principal role, so it's in the beginning of the movie. When y'all see it, make sure y'all show love and let me know what y'all think, because that was like my debut role. I've never did no act or anything before that.
So how many of y'all heard what the vice president said about him? Cops kill innocent black folk every day. Krell's coming after me, but I'm used to people coming at me. You feel? This shit been happening my whole life. But you know what I gotta say to these motherfuckers? If you wanna know what I gotta say to these motherfuckers?
See, unlike you, my constituents ain't Booker T. Washington motherfuckers. They're hustlers, street soldiers, and mothers trying to get off welfare.
Like all black leaders, you have a bullseye on your back.
I ain't no black leader.
They are gonna come after you. Everything you know. They are gonna give you the tools that you need to destroy yourself.
You on pop 24/7. It's on.
Well, I'm ready. That's what I do.
What the fuck is happening?
What happened to me? I got shot 5 times. If a nigga coming at me,
get him.
He gon' get killed.
Loyalty is everything.
The picture that you paint with your pen, that's your truth. But the picture the media paints, that's theirs.
The nigga gotta pay. He gotta pay for that shit.
Don't you throw your life away like I did. The whole fucking world will know Tupac. Now you're gonna be great one day.
You let them do it.
Above all else, divine old self, be true. I love you. And I know you are gonna survive.
I live in Covington. I was on my way leaving the gym, working out with my NBA skills trainer, Sean Sherman basketball, shout out to him. I was on my way working out with him, and then I got there to the gym and I got a text saying, Winston Sinclair, she's one of the top casting directors out in Atlanta. She wants to see you as Ray Love and All Eyez On Me. Can you hurry up and send the tape in? You got 1 hour. And I had to go to Fayetteville. Fayetteville's already 45 minutes away from Covington. So I didn't even have no money. My tank was on E. I didn't have no bread. I was still in college. I was, it's like my senior year of college. So I was eating Uber noodles. You know what I mean? That's how it was back then. So my coach gave me $5. It filled it up, got there, got on tape real quick, put the tape in. And then the next day, like around 11 p.m., they let me know, like, yo, you gotta be on set by 6 a.m. They pictured me really loud. So. And it was crazy because I was watching Straight Outta Compton, and the scene I was watching was where Tupac was in the, he was in the booth going in. So it was like, it was, I am up for the role. I didn't land a role, but I got something special. I'm not gonna tell y'all because I'm gonna wanna release it to y'all so y'all can blast it. I'm not gonna tell y'all what I'm gonna do, but it's something special that's coming around where I got JoJo, I got Stefan, I got Casey. It's something special coming to y'all that is really gonna blow y'all mind, and it's gonna have y'all think this is them. Like Hip Hop Weekly, all these blogs, and Bossip, everybody like blasting me saying we want y'all to be Dalvin. But I got some friends that actually look like the cast or whatever like that. So I'm like, yo, why not put my boys on, I mean, so we all could be lit. But I got something very special coming for y'all. Y'all gonna wanna see this, and it's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be amazing.
Hey, yo, what's going on? It's your boy, Stefan Washington, a.k.a. Stefan For You, a.k.a. Young Diddy on the new Tupac All Eyez On Me biopic. And I'm over here chilling with Branch now. We feeling real sexy, man. Get some Ciroc. Oh. To be honest with you, it was an accident. Yeah, I showed up on set for something else. I was just there chilling. And he was like, hey, my man, you look like Young Puff. I was like, yeah, that's what's up. And I just missed the scene. I got to go home. He was like, yeah, nah, hold on. He's like, what do you do? Look like Young Puff. And next thing you know, I'm sitting upstairs. Besides whoever Young Puff was at the time, I don't know his name. But next thing you know, I'm chilling with LT and the Young Puff, and they're like, yo, this is the Puff you got. But look at this guy right here. It became a situation. I guess you could say dude looked at me with the little death eye, little death stare. And then the messed up part, after they took both our pictures, like, all right, we'll be back in 45 minutes, then left me with just him. So,
he took his job.
He just sitting there with quiet, you know, I'm like, man. You know what's going on right now, brother. So, I mean, hey, that's God, man. That's a blessing. Right place, right time.
First thing that you get when you wake up to that morning love. I got an appetite for you. Oh, give me that morning love.
There you go. All
right, I like.
A little something, you know. And bad boy, baby, drink Ciroc, drink responsibly. Holla at y'all later.
Yo, what's good? It's your boy Daze, repping that Squilla Gorilla magazine. Y'all already know what time it is. When I'm in town, y'all already know what I'm doing. I'm branching out, so make sure y'all check him out.
We're back with Branching Out. We have Daze on the couch, and he's going to tell us about what he's got going on in Atlanta.
As y'all know, I go by the name of Daze. I run a company called Squilla Gorilla magazine. Which is a nationwide magazine publication, print and digital, and we just basically signed a new contract with Amazon Fire Stick, giving us our own television network. So we were doing right now, we're doing music videos, television shows, interviews, independent movies, independent films. But we put a lot of people's work in front of a screen. So you can basically, if you got Fire Stick, make sure you go get that SGX TV. Download it, check it out. We got countdowns up there. We actually bridging the gap between mainstream and underground.
Well, talk about your magazine.
Well, the magazine, I launched it a few years ago. Y'all might remember the magazine. It's owned by myself and Stevie J. We did a big premiere on Love and Hip Hop Season 4. I was the guy that set Margo up with Nico. And that's how basically the magazine got out there. But ever since that, we've just been doing a lot of positive stuff. From New York to Los Angeles to here in Atlanta. And we just basically giving a lot of independent artists the opportunity to get the treatment of a major artist. So we bridging the gap between mainstream and independent. Well, we was the first magazine to actually do the behind the scenes for All Eyez On Me. And we put out a whole issue dedicated to the whole making of the film. So that's available right now. We actually put that out like a year ago when they first finish the movie. So that's available right now on the website. Y'all gonna see issue 16, the All Eyez On Me issue.